Akron, 41 Marshall Avenue. Good evening, council members. I, of course, want to remind you all that I vehemently oppose new developments in the valley and attempts to frack on our watershed. I'm still waiting for council members and the mayor to release public statements on the campaign finance ties to DP Energy Auburn. More importantly tonight, though, I would like to bring a very pressing and unsettling issue to your attention. Serve the People Akron is a mutual aid collective that stands in solidarity with the unhoused populations of Akron. For close to a year now, we have conducted regular serves at Grace Park, where we provide food and supplies to folks on the streets. We do our best to be good neighbors and to lend a hand to those most in need. So we find it quite disgusting that the Akron Police Department, by whoever's order, has decided to harass and police us regularly. Just yesterday, while we were making supply drops at area encampment, we saw an APD cruiser, number 11, slowly drive by our vehicles, stop, and then take off. This was about 20 minutes after having seen Mayor Horgan bike past us on the towpath trail. Presumably, as the mayor, he was also on his way to help the less fortunate. I have no proof of that being the case. Several times while serving at Grace Park, we have also witnessed both regular police cruisers and unmarked cars drive past our parked vehicles in what we believe is an intimidation and harassment tactic. Further, we have good reason to believe that undercover cops and informants have attempted to blend into the houseless crowds to surveil us. These undercovers have been spotted doing laps in the park and have attempted to offer our members marijuana in a clear attempt to entrap individuals, which is also illegal and a violation of police conduct. We find it disgusting that the APD had a budget of $71 million in 2020, and rather than use that money to help those in need, they instead decide to police and surveil citizens who are merely feeding the houseless. Additionally, the CSX eviction of our heartless friends near the tracks at Grace Park is still a troubling issue. We have not been able to track down most of those folks who were displaced during the coldest period of this season, including elderly folks with disabilities who have not been taken into area shelters. Ostensibly, the CSX cleared these camps because of recent injuries and deaths on the railroad. But according to the Akron Beacon Journal, these deaths and injuries took place in 2019 on other parts of the tracks. I hope you take time to consider these troubling events and investigate these matters further. Thank you.
Good evening, Akron City Council members. My name is Shelley Pearsall. My address is 1660 Smoke Rise Drive in Akron. I'm a member of Preserve the Valley Citizen Action Group. Back in October, we created a petition on change.org calling on people to voice their support for saving the Tice Road property. That petition has now been signed by 15,600 people, many of them from Akron, and I'd like to read some of the Akron comments to council tonight. Tammy from Akron wrote, "This is a beautiful resource that should not be developed. Less homes, more trees." Kathy from Akron wrote, "We need to preserve our green spaces and protect the environment." Kelly from Northampton wrote, "I'm signing because that water runoff is going to flood my backyard creek and my front yard. And more importantly, Northampton doesn't need this development, nor does Mother Nature." Martha from Akron wrote, "Please protect the area from development." Ashley wrote, "I lived in Akron for 3 years. The quantity, quality, and ease of access to green spaces is one of the best elements of living in Akron. Please protect the area from development." Ashley wrote, "I lived in Akron for 3 years. The quantity, quality, and ease of access to green spaces is one of the best elements of living in Akron. The city should preserve and celebrate this, not destroy it." Jessica from Akron wrote, "Why on earth are more houses needed right here? Green space is our most valuable resource." Thank you.
Hi, my name is Ryan Keene. I have lived in Ward 10 in the Goodyear Heights neighborhood for the last 11 years and was born in Akron. I'm a member of About Face Veterans Against the War and a member of Serve the People Akron. I wanted to leave a voicemail raising some questions to City Council regarding the CSX illegal encampment sweep of the houseless community behind Grace Park on February 17th. CSX says that on February 10th, they notified the City of Akron and the Akron Police Department. Why weren't any members of City Council notified? Why weren't the houseless folks notified at the encampment. Why wasn't anything posted? Why did the city try to preemptively go down and talk to the tent city and let them know that CSX was coming on February 17th? Why does the mayor lend support to CSX, according to CSX, but not tell city council or the houseless citizens behind Grace Park about the illegal encampment suite? Also, there is nowhere marked or posted at Grace Park, a City of Akron public park, where the property ends and where CSX property begins. How far off the train tracks is CSX property before City of Akron property starts? So I think having that marked and posted would be a good step. Also, with as many committees and task force as there are for the City of Akron, mostly related around business and gentrification projects, I think it would be pertinent to have a committee for houseless folks with a couple members of city council on it, but also some civilian activists for the houseless that have been involved with the houseless, as well as some members of the houseless community themselves. The three deaths that were noted as a safety reason happened over 2 years ago, and one was a suicide. None of the three were anywhere near the Grace Park encampment, like the mayor claims. All three happened within 2 months, in spring 2019, from April to June, from the City of Akron, has requirements of either sobriety or religious. The Haven Arrest has religious requirements. There should be a low to no requirement programming for housing in the City of Akron.
Good evening, City Council members. It's Carol Coleman-Crane with Team Towing and Service.